my spiritual master quotes one story from Purana. He says that one time there was some disagreement between Indra and Brihaspati. Indra disobey Brihaspati and Brihaspati curse him, you become a hog. And Indra, king of the heaven, become a hog. It's a long story, but I'll say. And Brahma thought that no one is there. Indra post is empty. And there is no election, only selection. Isn't it? In heaven. So Brahma came. And Brahma knew, came to that hog, that swine. And he said that, "Oh dear hog, Prabhuji, you are a Indra. Do you know you are a Indra? You are king of the heaven." And this hog replied, Indra became hog. He replied, "What do you mean by Indra? What is the vyutpati and literally etymology of Indra? Please tell me. What is the meaning? What is the dictionary meaning of Indra?" He doesn't know how a hog can understand what is called Indra. And then Brahma had to explain what is called Indra. See, try to understand, the living entity remains in a particular body. Srotram chakshu sparsanam cha rasanam ghranam eva cha adhisthaya manasayam visayanu pasevate. 15th chapter. So it becomes habituated, used to that body. He doesn't want to leave that body. That Brahma had to remind him what is called Indra. The story doesn't end here. Please try to understand. After making him understand, explaining him what is called Indra, the hog asked that, "Is there any facility in the heaven, the type of facility I get here?" And you understand what kind of facility. What facility the hog is having. First he asked about, anywhere you go, two things you ask. Prabhuji, accommodation milega na? Padmanandji? He is searching for accommodation. Prabhu, he is saying, accommodation. Whether I can get accommodation in the heaven like here? What kind of accommodation? The sewage gutter. Whether I can get there? Brahmaji said, "What you are saying, this nonsense." Okay, if I can get the same foodstuff, breakfast, lunch, dinner, everything is hot. Such kind of foodstuff, if I can get there. So you can imagine how when a soul goes to a particular body, it becomes completely used to it and conditioned. That's called conditioning. And he doesn't want to leave that body. So therefore, here we discuss, Narad Muni says that the body doesn't belong to even the soul. Then in this verse he said, evam sadharanam. Then the body belongs to whom? He says, the body belongs to a common property. Body belongs to common property. Sometimes the mother says, mine. Father say, mine. Wife say, mine. Company say, nation say, organization, society, everyone say, this belongs to me, he belongs. It's a common property. The fire also says it belongs to me. The worm also says it belongs to me. Everyone says, it's actually a common property. And in this verse he said, evam sadharanam deham abhyaktam. What is the meaning of abhyaktam? Pradhan. According to Sanatana Goswami, this unmanifest abhyakta is pradhana. Pradhana means the fund, you understand pradhana? Pradhana is the fundamental state of material nature. Primordial state. So he said this body is, before coming into existence, it was where? In pradhana. And because it originates from it and dissolves again dissolves in it, still a person considers the body as oneself. It was not there. Suppose, how old are you, bro? suppose you are 30. 30 years before you are there? No. In some form, in some other, what kind of form, maybe. And now we are here, after some year, we will not be in this form. And during the complete annihilation, it will again merge into the pradhan. The same thing. And he says that abhyaktat means ishwarat. Ultimately it is coming from the God. Ultimately it is coming from the God. The body has an origination and a dissolution because of God. Abhyaktat ishwarat prabhavapyayu yasyatam. A person considers their body as their own. It was not there some 30 years before. It was in a different form. It is now here we see. You see me? Are you see me? I see you. And after 20, 30, 40 years, will not be there in a different form. Again, it will merge into the abhyakta. So he says, the word comes here, ko vidwan, kaun sa aisa vidwan vyakti hoga? Ko vidwan, vidwan means knowing the truth. Vidwan means learned person. Vidwan means scholar. Vidwan means vid. Tattva, tat tattvam jnanam. Ko vidwan, even though knowing this truth, that this body doesn't belong to anyone, it is common property, will engage in sense gratification, will engage in all sinful activities.